What's going on, guys? Bengal again here, coming back at you with the more Riverside Royals Dynasty. Just got crushed by number one Bama. We got to have an easier matchup here versus FCS East. FCS schools are, you know, typically significantly worse than your average bear, as they're not in the FBS. And this Mountain Cats team is the lowest overall team we've played in the entire series. And if it might be very close, but this is the first time in the series that we will be a higher overall than our opponent. Let me show you recruiting, because I still have some points left to allocate. And this is the first time seeing the updated board for me here, as we're still in the lead on Robert Sanders and Joe Patton. We're sneaking away a little bit with him, which would be a big upgrade to our offensive line. Want to get some big offensive linemen in there. And it's tough to get bigger than 6'7", 324. Could be in line to get this JUCO guard as well. Not putting any points into him. He's a plus six. Great value. But he's not very good. So I don't know about that one just yet. Steve Lewis, another junior college player. We're in the lead on him. Another great offensive lineman. I might get him and redshirt him, even though it would be a redshirt junior, which would be kind of weird to do that his junior season as soon as he transfers. But it would be better for his development. David Kendrick, I'm trying, man. I'm trying. I don't know how Louisiana, Army, Virginia, and Buffalo are all ahead of us. We have plus 230 on him. Why does he want to go to them? Don't go. I'm trying so hard to get him. And we're treading water. Trying to go after Joe Jones as well. Put some points into him. I don't know if this is working out. We're dropping a lot. I just don't think we can compete with, you know, SEC schools. And, of course, Oklahoma State in there representing the Big 12 as well. Ty Schmidt, we're dropping on him, which is sad, but I don't think we'll be able to get him. Want the tight end, but we're losing to Nevada. Losing to West Virginia on Phil Walker. We're dropping Johnny Wade, probably. It's not going that well right now on a lot of these guys. It's not going that well. So I think we may have to set our sights a little bit lower. We're going to have to take some of these guys off the board and reevaluate a little bit. We're not going to be able to get Travis Gibson. We're way too far behind on Marcus Hines. These are new players added to the board, but it is really tough to get some four-star recruits. It's just very, very hard. So we're going to have to take him off. Eric Ware, we're not even close. Jason Chambers, I don't think we'll be able to get either. John Austin, absolutely not. Try to go after a bunch of Cal guys. But, we're not even remotely close on being able to compete for these. But here is the game. First time we're ever ranked higher. Well, we're not ranked, but you mean we're a higher overall team. Better team on paper. Let's go and make this a blackout game. All right. Oh, I didn't change numbers. That's what I wanted to do. That's okay. It's all right. We'll do it another time or never. That's also an option. Could never happen. Of course, our new starting quarterback is junior college transfer Andy Byers. We need him to make some plays today. We need our defense to play well. But I would love to put on an offensive showcase against a team that's actually worse than we are. This is a must-win game. We cannot lose to this team. Let's start out on defense. Now, just because we're a slightly higher overall team doesn't mean we're going to mop them up, right? Should be an even matchup. At least you'd think that. As we're going to play underneath, and that is an errant throw by quarterback Daryl Berg. Brings up third and three. The blackout unis are pretty nice. They're pretty nice. There's a lot of yellow in there, though. I don't know if I like that. Looks all right. It's going to be a screen, and it's going to be Greg Hall getting the big TFL on Jason Higgins. Read that all the way. And FCS East, we're just going to call him East, are going to lose a ton of yards. and our defense held up strong. We're going to force a punt. Now, I would say this is probably the first game we're ever going to play where we might have noticeably better athletes at certain positions, as Andy Byers is going to take this up the middle, cut it out to the outside, and Byers is off to the races, trying to save a touchdown. Are the players on East? And they do, but it is a 39-yard gain by the quarterback running read option, taking it right up the middle. Good block on the outside, perfectly timed jump cut back outside, and a big gain for the Royals. We're going to try and throw that. Michael Hamm can't get it. I don't know what we're supposed to do there. I feel like we have an open man in Michael Hamm, who couldn't catch, by the way, last week. This dude dropped about every pass he could have, as we're going to run up the middle, cut it outside. Good block, and Byers trying for another first, and he'll get 9. Probably will be very tired, but already has 48 yards rushing. Let's try and give Trey Battle a carry here. Nice little draw play. Decent enough blocking, and Trey Battle's going to break a tackle. He's looking for space and finds it. 12-yard gain up the middle. That's open. Steven Williams will catch it and break a tackle. He'll get 6, 3rd and 5 now, as Byers is having a pretty good start through the air. 1 for 2. And this is a big third down. Really want a touchdown here, and we should have one. It's going to be a Dex Randolph TD. 3 receivers wide open to the right. The only thing that was stopping that from being a touchdown was an errant throw or a drop, or even another receiver like getting in the way of the throw and basically playing defense. But that will make things 7-0 Riverside. Defense started out strong, and the offense capitalized. Cruz trying to find the ball carrier, and Washington does get 3. That's good defense overall. I want to really dial up the pressure here, and I want Joel Pitts to start playing a little bit better. I know we played Alabama, right? It was his first game, but I don't think he really did much, as Jackson got fooled, and that's a nice tackle by Zaire Cruz. Man coverage across the board. Can't afford to make any mistakes here. And there are some guys that are open, but Hart is going to get the pass breakup. True freshman Allen Hart. We have a lot of true freshmen playing. Of course, they were major upgrades than what we actually had on the team. And he's got pretty good speed, the fastest corner, probably fastest player on the entire defense right now. And he's going to do a really good job. Offense back on the field for Riverside, but first it's going to be a Tyson Phillips return opportunity. That's not too bad. Oh, we're going to get sacked here. Yep, got to try and throw it away there. They just got too much pressure, and it's 3rd and 21. I mean, maybe we just... Ooh, is that safety coming up? That's a really bad decision. It's a really bad decision. Safety's going to blitz. We're going deep for Hamm. Michael Hamm has a step, and he drops it. This guy can't catch chlamydia in a whorehouse. Like, I get he's a true freshman. I get there will be some growing pains. I understand that. But man, as Neal's bumped out of bounds, thankfully, Michael Hamm has the speed to beat guys vertically. He doesn't have the hands to do anything. Yet I keep feeling like we have to give him chances, because if he does catch it, it's going to be a big play every time. But he just doesn't catch the football. What do we do with a player like that? It's a run, and Berg is shut down. Look who that is. Joel Pitts. We don't have him for long, right? Junior college transfer. He's not going to be, you know, ever like into the 90s. But he should be a decent player. He's one of the highest overall players in the team at 78 overall. He needs to step up and play well. There's going to be a pitch left. Make a play. Higgins has nowhere to go. Swarmed by Royals. That was sophomore Malik James making a nice play. Look at him get past 2 blockers to make that tackle. They're going 5 wide. Just check down. That's fine. Kenny Bush, he'll make the tackle. And East are going to be well short of the touchdown and will try a field goal from the right hash. That kick is up and good. staying inside. East is on the board here with three. Gonna pass, gonna throw, and man, this pass rush is really getting to us right now. That's open. Give me a good block. Trey Battle, you gotta be faster. He'll break a tackle, but he just didn't have the speed to get the first down running in a straight line, so he tried to juke it back and didn't really get a ton as a result. Third and six now. Probably looking to scramble if we can. And that's exactly what we'll do with Andy Byers. Just step out of bounds after seven. And a fresh set of downs. That's open. Byers finds Collins. And Collins can't find the ball. Because he also can't catch. I'm trusting Ham. I'm trusting him. He caught it. And he actually might be short. It's going to be fourth and inches from about the 45. I mean, we're not going to punt. We're going to give this to the fullback. Are you joking? Are you joking? Willie Briggs up the gut. Let's get it, Willie. Here we go. And it's a Willie Briggs first down. Go to the running back. It's Trey Battle. I want to throw to Ham on some of these plays. But I think he'll be my first down receiver, right? Where we'll take a shot if it's first down, maybe. Because there's not a ton on the line if we don't get it. As he's going to catch it, and that was a little bit dangerous. Had to work back to the football there. That corner pretty much played a hard flat. But Michael Ham actually caught the football. That's two tries in a row where he's actually come away with the ball, which is really nice and unexpected, to be honest. It's at second and four, read option. Byers is stopped for nothing. Third and 10. We're throwing it. That's a little bit underthrown, but Randolph holds on. 24-yard gain to Dex Randolph, the tight end. Not an amazing throw from Byers, but it's not a bad throw. It got there. It worked. Second and goal. Read option. Byers up the middle. He'll get four, and it'll set up a more manageable play here. We're going to try and sneak it. Byers up the middle. He's got it. And Andy Byers has a one-yard touchdown run. QB sneak on the goal line. Got to trust your offense. Got to make a play. And we'll go up 14-3. Ooh, little end around. Cruz, nice tackle. Second and five, we're going to work a little bit of a blitz. It's going to be a run. Linebackers right on it. You got to tackle them. Looked like that was started by Craig Jackson. True freshman starting at outside linebacker. He at least finished the play. That was another true freshman, Greg Hall, that actually got there first. Although he didn't finish. Third and five for East. Throw at me. Berg finding Thomas. And Thomas gets a big time gain on third down. Second and seven, thrown to the end zone, and Ben Miles has a touchdown. The true freshman, Alan Hart, hit him right as he touched it, but a really good catch through contact, as East is not going down easy. Only down by four. I probably go for two in this spot. Try to make it a field goal game, but they didn't do that. Read option, of course. Byers juking back to the outside, trying to find space up the middle. And that had big time potential. I don't think we tapped into it fully. I think that could have been a lot more. But a minute and a half, a little bit more than that, to work down the field and try to get into the end zone. As we're going to throw for Trey Battle, who ran over an East player. Got to throw that quickly. It's Phillips up the middle. Tyson Phillips, 22-yard gain up the seam. Good throw from Andy Byers. That's what we need to see. Got to throw that. Trey Battle is going to have another first down. And we could call our first time out here. I don't know if we want to do that. Let's keep trying to move the football. After this play, it'll be a timeout for sure if we don't score. Just throw it away. Let's be smart. Williams is uncovered in the slot. Let's force that inside linebacker to make a decision. We're rolling out. Byers has speed and is stopped short. We'll call our first timeout. That wasn't good enough there. He's definitely a little bit gassed right now. But I don't really know where to go with the football. Let's try a read option. It's a little bit bold on third down, but coming away with points and then getting football to start the second half is what my main goal is. As Andy Byers will keep it up the middle and will be just short of the goal line. Clock's ticking. We're going to call a timeout with like 2 seconds. We have a decision to make. Do we take our points? Or do we do what worked earlier? Which is run QB sneak on the goal line and get Andy Byers in. They're really stacking the box, obviously. But I think I like the matchup. Going up 21-10 would be huge. Let's try it. Byers forcing his way in, and he is short. No touchdown for Andy Byers. And East will take over at, I would bet, the quarter yard line. They're as far back as you could even be. So we're going to send everybody. And we're gonna bet that they run the football. And that is a safety. So it ended up working out. Instead of 3 points to end the half, we get two. And that was an interesting sequence. We're up 16-10 at halftime, and we'll get football to start the second half. Got to be a little bit better in half number two. Got to be a little bit better. All right, the second half is underway here. We're going to start with the football. Run counter right away from the safety blitz. Decent blocking, and Trey Battle's got good enough speed to make this a first down and more. Great start to the second half for Trey Battle. 19-yard gain, good blocking. They just sealed the edge just enough. Byers getting sacked. Anytime I call play action, we just become under such severe pressure. I feel like there's just not a whole lot of stuff to do. What if we call this play, which I think could be very effective in terms of yardage, but cancel the play action? Now, they're getting pretty good pressure in there anyway, and of course, like, I try to get in position to make the catch, and I hit triangle, and nothing happens. And I don't want to go for it here. I don't want to waste the timeout either. We're gonna take the lay of game or a false start, and then punt. Definitely an annoying sequence there, and the whole switching on to make the catch, that worked. I just got to get better at it, and it's been a couple years since I've played this game. Run up the middle. Higgins has the first 12-yard gain. A touchdown and an extra point gives them the lead. We should be up by a lot more. Missed opportunities. That's the story of the game right now. And of course, yeah, the team's far from perfect, but we need them to play better. Higgins in motion. Fake to the fullback. Berg's going to keep it. He's not going to pitch it. He's still going. What's happening? Big third and one. Tight end in motion, going to step off the line now, line up in the slot. And Berg going to take off and is nowhere to go. Sacked by Pop Jackson. Moved to D-tackle in the offseason in a more natural role. And he is making a nice play to bring down the quarterback. And it's fourth and six. FCS East will line up to go for it. Let's make a play. Berg throwing short of the line again. Got by it with James, and Miles luckily is short of the first down. We'll take over on offense. It also doesn't help, by the way, that we have two sets of guys with the same last name on defense. We have Pop Jackson, who's a defensive tackle, and Craig Jackson, who's an outside linebacker. And then we have Greg Hall, who is an inside linebacker, who's real good. And then we have Junior Hall, who's an inside linebacker, who's not real good. And there you go. There's an injury. I think it was Craig Jackson, 51, Seems more like a linebacker. Is that open enough? I thought so. Can't come down with it, though. Run up the middle. Good block. Trey Battle cuts back inside, and that's a first down for Trey Battle. Having a pretty good game, averaging 5.5 per carry. Might try and get him a little bit more involved in this second half. Running the ball has been effective. Throwing the ball has been inconsistent at best. Good blocks. Willie Briggs, good moves. Stumbling and falls forward for an extra one or two. First and 10. We have a step with Ham. He's going to catch it. He's stiff-arming. And Michael Ham has 14. You know, you'd think on the drag that his speed would be a little bit more apparent. He's definitely fast, but he's not as fast as you would expect. So we're going to switch to read option here. They're going to play the running back. Up the middle is Andy Byers, and he walks into the end zone for the score. Great blocking, and we will go for two to make this a 14-point game. Here we go. That's open enough. Collins just can't catch it. These guys not catching will be the death of me. Pitch right. Hall in pursuit. That's a really nice tackle on the edge. That's Ezekiel Sims, veteran cornerback. Doesn't really do anything well, but makes a nice play on that one. All right, cover zero. Nobody can screw up here. It's going to be a run. Berg, quarterback keeper, loses two. Is that Greg Hall, the true freshman with his second tackle for loss on the game? He's doing a good job of just being a heat-seeking missile, getting after the ball carrier. And he committed to the quarterback, and it worked out, made the play. Let's run some zone coverage now. We got Carlos Oakley up the middle. He's not on the field enough, an outside linebacker. As that's lobbed, where is Allen Hart, man? Allen. Just watching it, man. You gotta stay with him. Zone match, make a play. Second down, Hall in pursuit. Santos makes a really nice open field tackle on Jason Higgins, who's caused some problems today. Only averaging 3.6 yards per carry after that. But has been decent overall. As we have Pitts at linebacker, what's happening? What's happening? Berg gonna throw a screen. Sims has help from Greg Hall and stops East well short of the line again. And they will punt the football back. We're nearing the end of the third quarter. And I think a touchdown could do really, really well to basically end the game and get us our first win of the season. Tyson Phillips back to return. He's going to find a little bit of space. And a nice return to the 40. Counter. Oh, we got blocks. We got blocks. Battle to the outside. Back inside. And that's 13. And the end of the third quarter. Second and 10. We're just going to check down to Battle. He does a really good job to catch that. But it's third and 9. It's his seventh catch on the game, by the way. He's been very involved. But this is going to be... it's going to be a difficult first down to pick up. It really will be. Here's third and 9. Rolling out with Byers. We're going to have a blocker out in front. Make a block. Byers gains 17. Like, we had the option to kind of just pitch it to him, but had more faith in just getting there on the ground. Now, he's going to be pretty gassed after that. Maybe a carry or two to Trey Battle here in a row will be very successful. It'll also give him a breather. Battle up the middle. Huge shot, but it's a first down. What's the most amount of points we've ever scored in a game? It's got to be close. Back shoulder. And Michael Ham gets a touchdown. Nice throw. Right to him. Backside of the play there. Not back shoulder, but backside of the play. And Michael Ham actually caught the football. He's better at catching short than catching down the field. So I don't know what we do with him. Like, obviously you'd think some run after catch situations would be good, as Cincinnati barely beats Toledo. 4 minutes to play in the game. East down by 19. And that's just going to be lobbed up to Miles, who breaks a tackle, and he's got room to go after the catch. Hall tracks him down. It's a good gain. You know, they're not out of this one yet. They need basically three touchdowns and stops to beat us, but, you know, 29-17, who knows? We want to stop that from happening, of course, as they're going to go sideline and complete to Washington. He got 2 feet down. Of course, only need one in college, but he got two of them. What are they doing here? Going to the flat. Hall, huge shot. But Jason Higgins holds on to the football. Going to be a run. Oh, that's a nice play. Just getting in the run fit. Make a play. That's Kenny Bush. We don't see a whole lot of him anymore. It was a huge returner for us last year, as we just couldn't lock onto that. And I think Kenny Bush probably going to have to go back and return kicks again. Not that Tyson Phillips has been bad, just hasn't been as good. Just over 2 minutes to play in the game. It's a good drive by FCS East, but here's the problem. There's no time left in the game. They had blockers out in front. I mean, it's not over. I think this drive took a little bit too long. Onside kick try for East. Need this to stay alive. And they are going to get it. That bricked off the hands of 34. Another Royal had an opportunity to get hands on it. But they could not. And East still has a chance. Now, again, they're going to need to score quickly and get a stop, as somehow I can't lock into any animation on that despite being all over the freaking ball. Lobbed on the corner, and Thomas got a foot down. Now they're moving the football pretty quickly. Oh, not like this, man. Not like this. Got Kenny Bush out here. Let's play the flat. Surely they're not going to run here. And they're going to go over the middle and complete to Andrew Washington for 21. Now it feels like there's plenty of time left. A minute and 40 seconds. They have three timeouts. They score right here. They don't even need an onside kick. They're going to go up the middle. Oakley can't tackle him. And this is going to be, you know, probably an FCS East win. We can't stop them right now. 29-24, Riverside still holds the lead. They're going for the onside again, even with three timeouts. Well, you know what? They got it one time. We got Brett Claxton out there. Hopefully we get it. And that is kicked out of bounds. We'll get the football on or about the 40. And we just got to burn these timeouts. Played the running back. Byers, just slide. We're not going to be fumbling the football. But I think read option gives us a chance to just get out into the open field no matter what. They played the quarterback, we slide. If they play the running back, we just take it forward and don't fumble. Third and two. East has called their penultimate timeout. Only one remaining. Read option. They played the running back. Byers just going to slide. That's a first down. That's the final timeout by East. And that should be the game. Man, this game became pretty close at the end. An onside kick and an unstoppable offense that we didn't really see the rest of the game. And they almost came back to win. We had a 19-point lead. And we're only going to win here by single digits. Read option. Byers up the middle. Byers now to the outside. Probably just should have slid down. But that's going to be the final play of the game. Victory formation for Riverside. We get our second ever win. And our first win of the year. Byers will take a knee. And we get 10 XP for that. Nice. 24-29. I don't like that I said the losing score first. But that's big time XP. It's always really nice to get a win. And I think we played fairly well overall. Yeah, we were better overall than them. We should have won the game. And we did. Not much more to it than that. Andy Byers, 17 for 27, 152 yards passing and two touchdowns, was sacked twice. Rushing, he had 24 attempts for 128 and two touchdowns. That's four total touchdowns for Andy Byers. Trey Battle averaged 6.5 per carry, or just about 90 yards rushing. Willie Briggs was all right as well. He's only a junior, so we'll have him for next season. And then receiving, Trey Battle, 7 for 58. Touchdowns for Michael Hamm. I'm as shocked as you are. He should be really good. He's just got to stop dropping the ball. Touchdown for Dex Randolph as well. We're not really a pass-first offense, as you can tell, so some of these numbers are not that impressive. Greg Hall, Zaire Cruz, and Craig Jackson all had six tackles. Good to see the true freshmen up there. And they're atop the tackle for loss list as well. We had quite a few of them this game, including a sack for Pop Jackson, and of course, no interceptions. Definitely a really big week. We'll do the bye in this episode as well, so we'll add a little bit of recruiting in there. And it's nice to have a record not below 500. This is the first time in Riverside history we have not had a losing record. Think about that. Just loss, just kept losing. And we finished 1-9 and then 1-10 last season. And then started off this season 0-1. But we get a big time win. And we have some recruits that are ready to visit as well, which is also very nice. Cornerback Jeremy Thomas is ready for a visit. Surprise is not Tim Washington. It seems like, I mean, we're locking him up. We're doing real well to get him. But this is going to be a big visit for Jeremy Thomas. We got to stay in here. So what do we want? We get plus 400 late in the season on a bye. We think we can beat UAB? I don't really. I don't know. Should we try and get 400 points? I don't know. This is a weird one. Let's schedule them against UAB. And then our goals for that game will be four swatted passes, two picks, and beat a higher ranked team. That'd be a lot of points. Are they going to be ranked? Is UAB going to be ranked? Did I make a mistake? Steve Lewis, I feel like we're going to get. I'm looking at the cutoff point here. We're doing pretty well. I don't know when that actually kicks in, but we'll schedule a visit with him. And Air Force is now an option. We could host him against San Diego State, who we beat last year. The score doesn't change for any of this, so we'll just do it with an early bye. Well, it'll be plus 100. We're not going to get Ty Schmidt. We're wasting points. We're wasting our time. It sucks. We got to take him off the list. We're also wasting points on Joe Jones. He's not going to commit. Got to take him off the list. Joe Foster is a bit better than I thought. 6'4", 220. Catching is real bad. But, I mean, there's something to work with there. Do we offer him a scholarship? Might as well. It's 50 points. But he's not that good. We're going to lose Johnny Wade as well. We're going to get into a recruiting battle, but we're going to get cut off. Damn. And it's going to be a struggle to get at least one of those corners. I think we're going to get Joseph Brown, who's just a really good player overall. Where are we on the athletes? Show me David Kendrick if there's a chance. Minus 950. Oh, man. It's real tough. I don't think we're going to get him, but I'm going to keep fighting. I'm going to keep fighting to try and get him. But it's going to be a losing battle. So because we just took a lot of points away, I'm basically maxing out a lot of these guys, trying to either lock up these recruits a little early or get back in the race. And I added some points on Joe Foster as well, because I think there's a chance we can get him. And there's something to work with there, 90 speed at that height. And I do actually want to add new players to our board here. Hey, it's a Garrison. Maybe related to Paul Garrison. Doesn't particularly look like it, but maybe. We need to get some receivers, though. That's the big thing. And week 5 will be that matchup against UAB. I don't think they're going to be ranked, but I mean, you never know. It's a little bit weird. We're in season 2 now. So, I mean, crazy stuff has the potential to happen. So Steve got 100 points for visiting. I mean, that's just kind of, it is what it is there. Some other recruits ready to visit, though. So there is at least significant interest. And they are unranked. They're 79 overall. They're beatable. They're beatable. And Jeremy Thomas will be coming to our team this week. I think I'm probably going to take points off Robert Sanders. It's a player I think we're going to be able to get. 54% locked. He's ready for a visit as well. We might as well schedule that in this episode. He's another one. Offensive lineman. We'll bring him in this week. Why not? Joe Patton. We'll bring him in this week as well. All the offensive linemen just join this week. Phil Walker, I want as many points as possible, right? And it's only, like, all of these are plus 100, except for plus 300 in the final week. It is a bye week, but he's a player we really want. So we're going to try and do that. We're running away with Tim Washington, which would be a huge get for us. Be a massive get. He is amazing. Oh, Marvin Crenshaw is a gem. What's he good at? Tackling's pretty good. Power moves is pretty good. Block shedding's pretty good. He's a defensive end, probably, at 6'5", 262. That makes sense to me. Marvin Crenshaw would be a really nice get. We're competing with some good schools. But I suppose there's a chance. Dude, we're wasting points on David Kendrick. We're gonna actually, do we fight back a little bit? Do we get back under the projected locked cutoff? I think we did. But we're still really far behind. If we can just manage to stay in long enough to get to the offseason and put all our points in them to get our first five-star, that would be amazing. Bob Robb has 94 speed. Let's offer him a scholarship. Let's find out about some of these guys. All right, Jeremy Rice can go off our board. Austin Swain. He looks actually pretty good. He's a four-star that we're just not going to be able to get, though. I don't really want any 59 overalls. Scouting's been pretty bad so far. James Lee's okay. Not really much of a pass rusher. Joseph Jordan has 96 speed with 80 route running. Catching's not great. I need to go after guys where we have more weekly bonuses from. Like, Corey Warren would be good. How good is Corey Warren? He's a plus 8 gem! Oh my goodness. He's got 94 juke with 85 speed. This is a running back. Yeah, Corey Warren's getting a scholarship. We got to bring him up big time. Plus 8 gem. I've never seen that before. At least not in this franchise dynasty. But that is going to do it for this episode. We'll finish out by upgrading the coaches. Doing my best to recruit. We are certainly getting better as a team, but we got a long ways to go. And I might have to end up buying Locksmith. Might have to do that. Royal Treatment would be really nice as well, but I'm focusing on... It's got to be still the opener and then the closure, maybe. But we just got to keep upgrading our coach, and to do that, we got to win games. And for the offensive coordinator, I'm going to do plus 25% increase to stamina for games. I think it's going to be really important. So we'll do that. And our next game will be against 2-1 UAB. Right now, our recruiting board, you guys have seen it. We had a lot of guys scheduled to visit this week. And hopefully we don't lose out on these guys. Because I had to take off some points in some areas, add them in others. And eventually what will happen is we're going to take our points off David Kendrick because we're going to lose. But I really, really want this player. He just looks so amazing. 87 throw power, 87 juke, 82 elusiveness, 84 speed. Like, we could make him a running back. We could make him a receiver. We could make him a quarterback. He would be such an amazing dual threat QB. It would be insane. But it's going to be an uphill battle to try and get him, even stay in the conversation to get him. So my voice is going out on me here a little bit. That's going to do it for me, guys. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. Take it easy. You get in my way, then you best believe I'ma just run over you. Yeah, yeah.
so loud.